Well, when we think of remote communities, it's easy to think they're all out in the scrub. But spare a thought for the Aboriginal communities in towns and cities who are also being pushed out. Kennedy Hill is a tiny community that now finds itself fighting for survival on a piece of blue chip real estate in the middle of Broome. Danny Teece-Johnson sat down for a yarn with local elder Uncle Roy Wiggans.
Uncle Roy calls it the battle for Kennedy Hill. His piece of paradise is under attack from development, forced closures, and he fears a possible influx of Aboriginal refugees kicked off their own homelands.
This home was mine from the very beginning in 1945. I picked my wife here in this hill, picked her right over the thorn, see that thorn bush?
Yep.
That's
over there, eh?
That's where I picked her up.
Roy's son Rodney walked me through Kennedy Hill, which he says was once a thriving Aboriginal community that has been decimated by government policies. His young family now faces an uncertain future.
In 10 hours days, you know, we had a tent. All my old people used to have tents up here. And there was just one tree. There was just one tree way up on top of the hill there with this tin shack. It used to be a thriving community, but soon as all this started happening, you know, it's just far.
I done just about everything. But where is my life? This is the thing that worries me these days. Where is my life? What is mine? Where is mine? Just floating in the air? Or I've got a place where I can call my own. That's Kennedy Hill, Milling Bay Aboriginal Corporation.
According to Uncle Roy, communities that have towns built up around them, like Kennedy Hill in Broome, have cultural sites that are being destroyed, and the first people are losing their unbroken connection to the land. Kennedy Hill has a sacred corroboree ground that once echoed with the sound of dancing feet and ancient song.
And Dad used to tell us, you can only go far as that top there, not any further, not at the back of that down the hollow, or else come back here in the camp and play around here. I mean, that's what Dad...
Sacred site.
That's what Dad keep on talking about this area.
And for people who grew up there, like Lorna KELLY-COX, the memories of her elders dancing drives her spirit. She says they will never give up the fight for the Aboriginal communities across Western Australia.
What about the people that's buried in the in our land, in the country back home? Hello, Australia, time to wake up. Wake up, wake up. And let's all stand together and support each other.
The battle for Kennedy Hill is one of many being fought across WA and indeed across the nation. If anything, the threatened closures in the West have lit a fire in the belly of the Kimberley mob. A proud man from a proud people, Uncle Roy says, the fight has just begun.
I'm sick and tired of talking to people and fighting. This is my land, it's not white man's land. Women Shire and everybody else from white man's side of it, they pack up and go somewhere. I won't. This is my land, I'm not going to die here.
Denny Teece-Johnson, in Western Australian communities, for NITV News.